It is BlizzCon time, the convention for Blizzard, the video game developer of video games. And we've gone into BlizzCon this year under a bit of a cloud, surrounded by some notable controversy. As many of you will know by now, Blizzard banned a Hearthstone player for a year initially, shortened it to 6 months later, for making statements in support of Hong Kong during a Hearthstone stream. Blitzchung is currently not allowed to participate in official Hearthstone play professionally, in a move that many saw as Blizzard trying to placate China. And it's hard not to see Blizzard's decision in that light, since it mirrors so many other corporations that have engaged in suppression and censorship in a bid to, well, placate China, where many of these companies make tons of money. BlizzCon has already seen some protests from people who are angry about the decision, and fortunately for us, for everyone, and for Blizzard, the company addressed the situation at BlizzCon head-on, unwavering, unflinching, honest, open, direct. Only kidding. They issued a non-apology that said fucking nothing. I mean, seriously, it is some of the most impressively craven shit I've seen from a company, possibly in years. Quite a few gaming news websites have talked about this with the headline, Blizzard CEO apologizes. No! No, he didn't! He didn't! He said the word sorry, but he didn't actually apologize for anything. Fucking J. Allen Brack adopted puppy dog eyes and had a sorry tone in his voice, but he said fuck all. And as far as we know, Blitzchung is still suspended, so it's actually really unclear why he's saying sorry in the first place. Because the suspension is something Blizzard's actively doing. They are doing it. It's not done, insofar as they could lift the suspension at any time. So if they're sorry for that, and it's not clear, because J. Allen Brack, remember, said fucking nothing, they could actually do something about it, but they haven't as far as we know, so they're not sorry for that, leaving one to wonder, what is J. Allen Brack sorry for? Getting caught? Getting in trouble? That seems to be the only fucking thing. Let's watch the apology together, and I might interject with some thoughts of my own.
You know, Blizzard had the opportunity to bring the world together in a tough Hearthstone esports moment about a month ago, and we did not. We moved too quickly in our decision making, and then, to make matters worse, we were too slow to talk with all of you.
A tough Hearthstone esports moment. What's that then? Are you gonna name any names involved? Any countries involved? Any events involved? What is a tough Hearthstone esports moment? For reference, this is as far as Brack goes in upfront addressing what happened. No description of the event, no names, nothing. Just a heated gamer moment! Sorry, I mean a tough Hearthstone esports moment!
When I think about what I'm most unhappy about, there's really two things. The first one is we didn't live up to the high standards that we really set for ourselves. And the second is we failed in our purpose. And for that, I am sorry and I accept accountability. So what exactly...
Don't applaud for that. Why applaud for that? He didn't say anything. High standards for what? We didn't live up to our high standards. How? What? Why? When? What did you do that's wrong? We don't know because apparently you're still sticking with a suspension. So what are these high standards and how did you not live up to them? Fucking say something, you goon! Don't just let an arrangement of words spill out from under that mane of hair. Say actual things with substance and fucking meaning. I think my favorite bit though is where he stops talking for a moment, clearly expecting the round of applause. Feels like he's not gonna get it, starts to speak again, then the applause comes and he gets a little smile on his face like, there it is. Because that's what this by the numbers corporate non-apology is. It's designed to get certain reactions from certain audiences that are all too quick to forgive a company because it makes their favorite games.
So what exactly is our purpose? BlizzCon is demonstrating it even as we speak. We aspire to bring the world together in epic entertainment.
No, that's the wrong company, mate. You're Blizzard, you do Diablo, they do Fortnite.
And I truly believe in the positive power of video games. When we get it right, we create a common ground where the community comes together to compete, connect, and play, irrespective of the things that divide us.
Fuck off!
As an example, BlizzCon has people from 59 countries all around the world here at the show today. And that is the positive power of video games. To transcend divisions that surround us in so many of our places today. We will do better going forward.
Better at what? Better at what? You haven't actually told us the bit you failed at. You haven't actually described the thing you did wrong. Which bit of this, which part of this do you think you did wrong? You say you were too quick to act and too slow to respond. But what was the action and what was the response? What part of those actions and responses are you actually sorry for? Details, man. Detail. No, just not even details. I won't even be that greedy. Detail. A detail. Give us a detail.
But our actions are going to matter more than any of these words.
Actions like suspending and then upholding the suspension of a professional Hearthstone player.
As you walk around this weekend, I hope it's clear how committed we are to everyone's right to express themselves. In all kinds of ways, in all kinds of places. I've actually seen and heard many of you expressing yourself this morning. You use your vacation and your family time to be here in Anaheim with us, and we are so grateful that you're here this weekend. Our best moments are here in our shared passion for Blizzard games.
Didn't get the round of applause that time, did you not?
So once again, BlizzCon has brought us together, and today you're going to see a lot of the hard work of the Blizzard team. I am personally so proud of what we are building, and I hope you love it too. Thank you for joining us.
Anyway, that wasn't an apology. That was an attempt at placation. That was placation. I mean, I say an attempt, clearly for the audience in attendance, the marks in attendance, it worked. That wasn't an apology. An apology is where you acknowledge what you did and you're sorry for it. You don't just go, sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. We will do better. We will do better. When a dog steals a sausage off your plate when you're not looking, it'll hang its head and look up at you with a little face that says, I'm sorry. But the dog don't mean it. The dog doesn't acknowledge what it's done wrong, and it's got a yummy sausage in its tummy, so it doesn't actually give a fuck. It seems like Blizzard's whole MO this year is placation. They have tooled their announcements to try and get people to forget that they might ever have been angry at Blizzard. They've got that 1-2 punch of big announcements, which many before BlizzCon thought would be used to try and sweep the whole Hong Kong thing under the rug. And in many ways, it's worked. I mean, they've used these big game announcements to try and overshadow the Blitzchung thing. They make this pathetic, pitiful, cowardly non-apology. And it is cowardly. J. Allen Brack's mewling, driveling non-apology was the work of fucking cowards. But unfortunately, Blizzard knows it's in the video game industry where, you know, sticking to one's guns is rare. Controversies are often short-lived, especially if you've got a big game announcement in the works. So they can shit out a quick, sorry, we fucked up, without ever actually acknowledging how and why and what they fucked up. And they know a whole bunch of marks are going to accept it because they want to be excited about Diablo 4. I gotta hand it to Blizzard. Like, I was expecting BlizzCon to be hilarious, and it's not, because they knew exactly how to play their audience this year. I guess Blizzard's humiliation in the wake of the Diablo Immortal announcement last year has taught them a thing or two. But not everyone's fooled, and anyone who can stop thinking about Overwatch 2 or Diablo 4 for even a second can look at this apology, this fake apology, and see it for what it is. A very carefully contrived performance. A perfectly performed appearance of sorrow that says nothing, commits to nothing, does nothing. Anyway, that Diablo 4 looks good, doesn't it?